welcome back to Press X for Chromosomes, Dragon Age 2.
Whoa. Get on our way.
Yeah. So we're going to... Okay, that's that one. That's... Jesus.
Might as well go to that one.
I'm not... I'm going to go do this one.
Okay.
First. This one.
Okay.
The find the guy's buddies.
Monies?
Children, actually. I said buddies.
Oh. I heard monies. But my ears are kind of... broken right now, so.
And I was fidgeting too, so I was like, nah, eh. I was like, my pants are falling down. I need to pull this shit up. There's no business being around my ass crack.
We're recording? Perfect time.
Yeah, exactly. Hopefully, you guys hear the squeak of the couch.
Yeah, whereas whenever I adjust, my boobs always hit the fucking pop filter.
Oh, yeah, naturally.
Spunk.
Fortunately, I'm too short, but you know, one day. Yeah. Living the dream. Living La Vida Loca. I like how we came out where we fucking dropped off Bethany.
Yeah.
Even though it's like the exact same place where we started.
He says this is where we leave you.
I am so not used to this game anymore. Like, because we played Inquisition.
Yeah.
On the PC specifically for me. But I was like, how the fuck do I play? Especially because I'm playing an archer now.
Right.
I'm like,
how's
really
that
like.
Going?
I love it, but I love the archery from, like, the multiplayer and shit like that, because it gets really OP.
Oh, I'm sure.
So, I'm like, yeah. But it's going fine. I had to figure out how the fuck to kind of continuously attack, and it turns out you hold down the mouse button.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know that. I thought you just had to fucking, like, click it once and it would do it, like in Origins, but it was... Nope.
Yeah, no.
So, I had, like, an auto-attack button, because I was like, the hell? How do I do shit?
I don't know anything.
Yeah.
I thought he got his legs chopped off briefly.
Mistress Hawk?
Wouldn't make much of a difference. He's already short.
Right?
My brother, Marin, I one locked him in with the Darkspawn. He sealed the door, left me here and bolted for that passage. He's gone mad. All he cares about is that damned sword.
Is the sword red?
Right. No. I'm gonna just...
Another greedy dwarf. You think he took lessons from Bartrand?
Maybe. But greed is hardly exclusive to dwarves.
Maybe I mean, you're not wrong.
I thank you for calling that out. Dude, I was like, Jesus, that's not what I signed up for. Sword,
but I never imagined
Jesus.
Leave us to rot. This is getting just a little too familiar, isn't it? Please. I don't want my brother.
I mean, you don't know yet, but the fucking entire area is like lit up with fucking...
Red Lyrium.
Yeah, I'll save your brother.
Get back to the surface. Looks like I have a date with the Darkspawn.
Fuck that sword.
Bring flowers.
He'll get himself killed.
You need to find a way to reach him. Please, come
fucking
tell
kick
my
down the door.
As soon as you have
I am room. A goddamn warrior. An Inquisition I could do it.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice being able to pick locks. Well,
I'm sure it is.
Hold on. Hold on, man.
Hold.
I got
fuck up.
Hopefully spiders rain down on me.
Yep.
You can tell when it starts lagging.
The monsters are going to spawn in.
Yeah.
At least this isn't the PS4 where it'll fatally close without a warning.
Yeah, but half the time it doesn't fucking even have these, like, super,
heavy times.
Yeah, like frame rate drops.
No, but the game was acting a little weird with, like, your targeting system and that kind of stuff.
With Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
I think that's just Final Fantasy, too.
That's fine.
And me just having extra trouble with it and being a little bit easily more annoyed.
Maybe when I play it, eventually it'll be at the same point. And we can just go, nope, it's the game.
Yeah. Or maybe they'll fucking patch it.
Or maybe they'll patch it.
To be fair, just I've got like how... no fucking updates because my goddamn...
Yeah.
I feel like I should update anyway. I feel like that's kind of shitty. To like, no, you can't be connected to the network, so...
So you can't update your games.
Yeah.
Yeah. I can't remember what I was going to say. Oh yeah, just like how like in Pokemon, in Oris.
Mm-hmm.
No, not Oris. X and Y. There was a glitch where you couldn't save outside in Lumos City. You had to save inside the building or outside of the city. Because there was a glitch where if you saved on the street in Lumos City,
yeah.
Closed the game, and reopened it, there was a high chance that you couldn't ever recover your game.
By the stone. Jesus it, Christ.
It just corrupted all the Wait. Data. You would have to restart.
I'd be mad.
And,
I can't believe it's you. I had no idea.
Nintendo actually released like this, a large patch that fixed Everywhere. The problem. You had to, like, download it off the store, but it was free.
That's good. And it was well, like, I hope as a patch.
Like, this is a patch. Take it. And then you just, you know, ran it like normal software and patched the game.
Yeah.
Which I was just like, fucking thank God. Even though I think at the point where the patch came out, I was done with the game. So I was like, I don't care.
Yeah, but
I'll get it. I'll get it just to run around and have fun. But
I still can't.
I'm glad. Oh. Speaking of, like, I was going to say, like, I wish I could have my Pokemon back from it. But they're fucking updating the game, like, sometime in January, so you can transfer your Pokemon over.
Oh, shiny.
They're doing, like, the Pokemon Bank thing again. I was like, yes, I can have my fucking shiny Gardevoir and my shiny Skitty.
Well, maybe hopefully by that time you'll have a shiny Cutie Fly, too.
That'd be cool.
Oh, and also, so my friend, who is pretty much a Pokemon breeding master, told me that if you give a Pokemon an Everstone and chuck it into the daycare, whatever Pokemon's holding the Everstone is more likely to have the baby of that same gender. So if you have a female Pokemon holding the Everstone, the baby is more than likely going to be a female.
Weird,
right? But I was thinking, I have a female Salandit.
Yeah, you can fucking
I love the shiny female Salandit.
Same. I can't believe how fast, though. Like, I mean, I guess it makes sense, but like, I was like, I put like a Comfy up or whatever. I was like, I want a female Salandit or whatever. It's and gone. Someone just fucking immediately jumped on that shit.
I'm trying to get a Krandios.
Yeah.
Which is one of your fossil Pokemon.
Yeah,
I'm trying to get one of those.
I can breed mine for you.
I've had Delmice up there for fucking like 4 days.
Weird.
Any gender, any level.
To be fair.
Anything. And
there was something I was looking for. I can't remember what, but it wasn't anything like super like rare or anything like that for like my Comfy, and it took a while.
Yeah,
and I was like, the fuck.
I eventually just searched for it myself and I found it.
Mm-hmm.
And I traded my Relicanth for it, which I was like, whatever.
Yeah, whatever.
But and just to get a Krandios so I could fucking get the damn codex entry.
Yeah.
And and then I think I put Delmize up there again for fucking Relicanth. But at this point, I don't care.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, he's dead.
Thanks, man.
That's Iwin, isn't it? Poor bugger. Doesn't look like he got a chance to use the control rod. Maybe the golems are further in.
Let's poke around ourselves.
Yeah, fucking, I'm gonna get that sword anyway. But yeah, no fucking. I think it's just weird sometimes when it comes to that shit.
Yeah. Or people aren't looking for Delmizes anymore, so
quite bad. I flooded the market with goddamn Comfies. But the thing that's kind of comforting about Pokemon is the fact that
it's a constant.
No, thousands of stars. I was trying to fucking discern whether these guys were fighting out, me
yeah,
or not.
Same.
But whether or not fucking but people, thousands, millions of people play this game worldwide. So there's probably going to be someone that
there's always going to be a market for something.
Yeah, exactly. And I fucking found me a Comfy. And I love trading it because it's cute. People like it.
Once I start breeding Salandits, I might flood the Wonder Trade with female Salandits.
I was flooding it with fucking, like, Comfies, but I kind of got annoyed. I kept getting goddamn, like, Abras. I was like, fuck off.
So, all I can think of is the one time I fucking put up a Ghastly, I think it was.
Yeah.
And got fucking Solego out of it.
Oh, yeah!
Yeah. But the Solego was holding Leftovers.
Yeah.
Which is an item that you can only get in the Battle Royale.
Yeah.
So I was like, oh, I need to give Owell some Leftovers. That way he can just constantly heal after everything and I don't have to keep wasting my damn berries on this.
Yeah.
So I was like, I'll just get him Leftovers. And I was like looking up where to buy Leftovers. I'm like, God damn it, not the fucking Battle Royale. And I tried the Battle Royale and it sucks.
I hate the Battle
Royale. I'm not great at it.
And I won one finally, but it's such because it's such a random mix that I'm like,
it really is.
How the fuck am I supposed to know? And I also didn't entirely understand how it worked at first, but eventually I kind of got it.
Yeah,
but it took me like 7 tries to fucking kill, like win.
Right.
Because I'd be like, and the thing that would piss me off is I would be like the last one standing or something like that, but I'd still lose
because you didn't kill
the most dudes. And I'm like, yeah. Fuck that.
Yeah, like, Anders, my thing too is just like. Oh, I would, I'm aiming for that Pokemon because it's got the least amount of health. Oh, great, someone else hit it first and crit.
I don't get that, too, if that's, like, a speed thing.
It is.
But still, it's, like, fucking, like, my goddamn Primarina isn't that slow. I know it fucking knocks it back down to goddamn,
A level cap.
Yeah, 50, but still, I'm like, what the hell?
Yeah.
Also, the fact that, like, they're, like, oh, normal thing starts at 50 is bullshit.
No, definitely, because you're introduced to it when you're like, what, level 20?
Yeah, or less. Yeah, pretty fucking early on, so I was like, the hell?
Yeah, no, that's ridiculous.
We're too late. Darkspawn smashed the chest.
Maybe there's still something to salvage in this mess.
Meh. Definitely not that chest.
Anders, are you fucking... Oh, God damn it.
But... So I was looking at the Solego for some reason, holding leftovers, and I was like, yeah.
That's awesome.
So I have leftovers.
Nice. That's really
cool. Didn't even have to fight to get it.
Yeah. Now I get to keep my fucking Cosmog.
Yay.
If Cosmog didn't suck.
I do Cosmog. Have Lunala for you. Did I tell you that?
Yes, I believe you did. I wonder if we can get over here.
Give me a trash Pokemon.
Yes.
Because at this point, I think that's all I need left from Sun. Oh, no, I need that fire turtle thing.
Yes.
That's not Torkoal. Torkoal's older brother.
I think I got you one of those.
Oh, hey.
But I don't know.
Eh.
I haven't played Pokemon 2 for a really long time at this point. No. I had to take a break.
Do we want to do Sunder while we're here?
No, because we tried to do that.
That's right.
That fucking, that
that's
was like
right.
One of those last episodes, and we're like, "Fuck, man!" Because yeah, and Meryl's being a bitch. All right, I'm gonna fucking give a thing to the dude down here. Go back to fucking like the gallows. Give a things back.
Sounds great.
Then do other things, but and then we can fucking continue our goddamn main quest soon.
Hell yeah!
Yeah, boy! Yeah. My longest yeah, boy ever. Yeah, boy.
It's so like
these guys are just yelling. That's why they're covering the ears, because it's like glass.
Yeah, his nails on a chalkboard.
God, watching that fucking Shrek game or whatever. The fucking, I'm like, there needs to be regulations on goddamn noise in video
there
games,
because really
like I made a face, homie made a face, and I was like, jeez, I had to like take off my headphones. I was like, that's unacceptable. I know it's like an indie game, so there's no fucking regulations, but I'm like that's not allowed.
When my parents and I went to go see Rogue One in the theater, where it has that really fucking loud commercial, I'm Batman. I work at the theater now.
Oh, yeah. That's a specific, like, for you guys, it's not anything that's in any other theater, probably.
It's
a specific fucking local commercial for that theater.
And
it's like, it's kind of charming, but, like, they don't have a good, they never took comedy classes or anything like that. So it's
80% louder too than every
other they didn't fucking goddamn edit it correctly on the premiere. Probably only half premiere, to be honest.
I was sitting there literally with my hands over my ears.
Yeah.
And I could still just kind of, I was like still like wincing at like the fucking loud parts.
You think that they would like watch it? Or they notice in the theater how much louder it is compared to everything, and they would edit it?
I meant to actually, like, try to find management and be like,
can't you guys
need,
turn that shit down?
You need to, like, yeah, because...
That's fucking loud.
It is loud. You're gonna hurt someone's ears.
Yeah, you're gonna fucking... You should be testing for noise damage after that shit.
Yeah.
It's so loud.
And, like, just not, like, I'm not mad. Just, you guys need to do something about it.
Yeah, like, turn it down. Like, edit it and turn it down.
Yeah.
If you want, I'll do that for you. It's not
a
fucking hard thing.
I have Premiere. Give me, like, $100 to edit it.
Yeah.
I'll do it as a public service. Give me free movies for a year.
Yeah, I was gonna say, give me like $50 a movie.
Yeah. That's two movies.
Because it'd be like two button clicks on Premiere.
No, seriously.
It's so
it
fucking
would.
Easy. And I'm such a person, like, man, I want a gouge, but I'm so fair.
Yeah.
Because I hate, like, as an individual, like, that's so fucking skeezy.
Yeah.
I don't like being ripped off.
So
I have a hard time ripping off.
But yeah, no, it was great because afterwards, after the commercial ended, went to the next commercial. I looked at my dad and went, I think they need some noise control. My dad was like, it's a little loud. And I was like,
it's like, I think when we were watching it in the theater, when we saw like Moana or something like
yeah.
that, I think you or I or whatever pretend to be blown back by
it
because it's so
you.
Fucking loud. Yeah. And like, it's a, just like, put the image in your mind of like when somebody is in like a wind tunnel, but they open their mouth so their cheeks are doing like the fucking
yeah
thing.
Yeah, like, I told my dad, I know how to use Premiere. There can't be no one who works at the theater who doesn't know Premiere.
Depends on goddamn their fucking, what they, like their hobbies and shit like that.
That's true.
I mean, it's very, I didn't know how to use Premiere until fucking
this
late into
happened.
This channel, though. Like halfway in between.
God,
because,
2 years?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah.
Because it finally was affordable.
Yeah,
or,
thank
that's
you.
That's the whole thing with Adobe. It was just finally goddamn affordable.
That's the thing that frustrates me with Microsoft Office is it wasn't cheap.
Mm-hmm.
It was, I think, $60 or $80 for Office, for the basic Office. $60 or $80.
It's not bad, though.
It's not.
It's not like fucking
bad.
Thousands,
it's not, yeah,
like fucking
it's
Adobe was asking for.
$600 like Adobe. So there's absolutely no reason other than taking advantage of the damn market
mm-hmm.
of, oh, we can now make the subscription based
and get more money just annually.
Yeah. And I still laugh because I still have not gotten charged for the one copy I bought 3 years ago when I got
nice.
My laptop. It's never asked for a payment update or PayPal.
That's awesome.
And so my friend was like talking on Twitter about like, God damn it, why is Office like a, you can't just buy it outright. It's $100 a year. And I was like,
what? I have like a $5 a year or $5 a month subscription.
I'm in your debt. Please take this as
that's thanks. Just what she posted.
Yeah.
But I was
she might have been looking at the suite because I only pay for Office.
Oh, yeah. No, she's probably looking at the entire thing.
Or Word.
Yeah.
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 Word,
bro. But,
I just go up here.
So, yeah, I almost tweeted back at her being like, I've had this bitch for 3 years and they've not asked for money.
Don't fucking let them on to you, though.
Yeah.
Sassy walk.
Or
sassy
just
guard.
Like, or just get Open Office. Like, it's not as amazing.
It does the job, though.
Yeah, for freeware, it's not bad.
I like having Office, though, for like professional documents and shit like that, because it does. Everyone fucking has Word.
Open Office can save as a doc.
Oh,
file.
Well, like DocX.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, that's it can nice. Save as a docs file. It prefers to save as an ODT.
Which is probably
open.
Its thing.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, ODT is.
So it's like, that's
but
not a.
It's. Normal. It's interchangeable. Like, I still have ODTs that I will open up in Word.
Oh, nice.
And continue to save as an ODT. It's nothing bad.
Yeah. Okay.
Just don't save as a fucking text file, because then you lose all your formatting, and it's very frustrating to try and go back and edit everything.
I believe it.
Coming from somebody who has edited documents to put in HTML, it is a bitch.
Yeah.
Years of nice.
Can I take off your crown and stab you with it?
It'll fall off his head, don't worry.
I know why.
Yeah. His head might fall off too.
I'd lose my head if it wasn't attached to my neck.
Huh, weird. Thanks for giving me your weak point.
Yeah.
Like, what? That's for everybody. It's not a specific my only weak point.
It's humans' weak points.
I didn't know it was just as annoying for him.
Achilles walks in. He's like, I'm like my heel. You're like, what?
Right. Meanwhile, I'm just like having flashbacks to like when I started up Inquisition as a Canary, and Varric's like,
keep the worst of them off.
So
be all right.
You're.
But that is the problem.
You're not a Canary. You're Talvashoff.
It has already escalated, despite your efforts.
Yes. I remember when they're Canary and Kirkwall. They were fucking assholes.
I was a dick on my Canary playthrough. I'm also making like I was talking to my buddy, and I was like, I'm fucking, Cassandra's gonna hate me. I'm being like, combative immediately.
Right. Oh, my little twist to Cassandra, my favorite thing is if you're playing a mage, I don't need a staff.
I didn't do that, but I was also like, for some reason when I'm playing mage, I'm like, oh! I'm like super all like nice and like civil, but like anybody else, like this character, like, and with my like main inquisitor, I was like, oh, all right, I'm trying not to piss you off or whatever. But this inquisitor, I was like, I don't fucking give a shit. And she's like, disapproves. And I'm like, fuck off. The little like flipping face. Yeah.
With my elf mage, he was definitely more of a, fuck this at that point. Now. Like,
God damn it.
Like with Liliana. Kill him. Very hard. Fuck, that screwed me over hard. But like,
yeah, she's like, I want to kill him. And I was like, don't. But I was like, kills him anyway. About it. I was like, I thought you were smarter than this. And she's like, fuck, fine. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, that bit me in the ass. But he was very much more of a, you want to kill him? Do it. I don't care. I'm not going to get involved in your shit. My Canary's going to have a fucking heart of gold. I'm gonna make him the sweetest little dipshit ever, even though he does not look like it.
I would prefer that my person looks like a bitch and is a bitch.
So where would you start if you were the starting
Oh my.
I would begin with the most obvious failure. It's clear the City Guard has no excuse for allowing this. Unless
I
they were
to play
involved.
More of my nightmare playthrough. I haven't even made it to the breach yet. Number of
recent recruits well, have oh, seriously?
To be fair, I only played for 45 minutes, and half of that was the fucking character creator.
True, that's true. I fucking...
By the time I got to fucking that part...
That one night, I made it to fucking... because I thought we were going to get back on, so I was like, I'll just kind of dig around till then, so I made it to fucking Valrio, and then I was like, I don't think she's getting on, because it was like 5 a.m.
Yeah,
and, like,
that's
when
I really fell asleep downstairs. Yeah. Like, I fucking passed the fuck... To be fair, when Hamilton sleeps on me, because he is a little furnace.
Oh, yeah. Animals. I was going to say cats, but I was like, fucking animals.
He's not a dog. He's not a cat. But he fell asleep on me, and I just...
Now she wants to talk.
Of course.
She had to wait for a fucking plot point.
Of course. I just... Whenever he sleeps on me, I just crash hard.
That's understandable.
Yeah.
Might be a comfort thing, too.
Oh, yeah. It's been quite a while since I've had a doggy
I always
want to
save in front of her, but whatever.
I've got something to show you.
I've seen it.
Come and see.
I've fucking invaded your privacy many a times.
We are on the fast track.
What?
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Shit.
Sure. Middle?
Of all the giant mirrors in your house, Meryl, this is easily the nicest. I knew if anyone would understand, you would.
Sassy, but still got the point across.
One of my clan found it in the Brazilian forest, we think. Poor Tamlin. We never found him. Just the shattered pieces of the alluvion. I'm sure you wouldn't show something this dangerous.
I'm being nice, because she hates us so nice. Much.
She still disapproves when I'm nice to her.
The mirror won't hurt anyone.
Well, with this, she really wants to fucking.
Every time she says that. She has no idea.
Anders,
I didn't invite you here. He's like, I was in your party.
Totally under control, but it doesn't work.
This is jumping around so much
because it doesn't happen if he's not there.
Finished with a special tool, and a ruling home, and my clan has one.
Fortunately, Anders is like the easiest dude to please, but like,
he really is.
He does not like what Meryl gets into.
No.
But you're afraid to face
the He's like, again. For fuck's sake, Hawk. Exactly. God damn it. Why is he like white halo guy? And then we're like black as fucking night in this room.
Or talk circles around each other. She has a disappointed friend.
Move Ander to our spot.
Today.
We move in his spot. Oh, not look now. You fucking will, it's all you? Makes
Better.
Sense. Yeah.
I'll go with you. Maseranus. I'll find some way to repay you. I promise.
It's don't turn that thing back on. Hey!
Oh!
We're going to be at the midway point now.
Huh?
We're going to be at the midway point now with her.
She's going to fucking like still... Oh, I forgot this was the dump. where you take your number twos.
Your squat.
Yeah.
Your squatty potty. So during our gift exchange, because we always have a gift. We used to call it the adult gift exchange because only the adults could do it. But now it's just the gift exchange because pretty much everyone's over like 21 16.
Or 18.
Pretty much everyone's out of high school except for my youngest cousin, but she doesn't want to be a part of it. She prefers watching, which is all right, sure, whatever.
Interesting.
She just thinks it's more fun watching than participating.
Fuck her. Let's bring her down a peg for her fucking I'm better than you attitude.
It's not I'm better than you. It's just more of a that's what she prefers. But so
fuck her for preferring that now.
So my cousin comes in with an Amazon box that has scotch tape on it, and on the top is written in Sharpie, gift exchange. Not wrapped. It just says gift exchange.
There we go. Jesus.
And he's like, yeah, I didn't have time to wrap it, so here it is. And I was just like, what the fuck? Oh, whatever. You have a kid, I understand. And so we get to the point of the gift exchange.
Mm-hmm.
And my cousin's wife tells his brother, his wife, you know, tells his husband's brother, you'll really like your brother's gift. I think you should open it and, you know, see what it is.
Yeah.
And he's nice and gullible, so he goes, okay, cool.
Sure.
He grabs it and he opens it and it's a fucking squatty potty. He loved it.
I mean, teach their own.
Like, he's just like, I wanted one of these. And he's just like, because usually when people are trying to get rid of their stuff, when someone's like, you know, considering, they'll like present it, be like, do you want this? And like, they'll talk about how great it is. He just sat on his. Like, he had his like, feet on. He was like,
like,
on
you
Twitter.
Sat on that fucking, like, wine.
I literally sat on that box, yeah. Though. Like,
it's a cool box.
Yeah, I didn't just have my feet on it like my cousin did. I was literally sitting on it. And then the moment I turned my back, fucking my family friend stole it from me and put it under her seat. To which I was like, we're past the gift exchange. This bitch is mine. Also, that was your gift that you put in there, so give it.
Yeah, you can't fucking have it back. Piss face. Well, the box wasn't in it. Fuck, wasn't part of it. Fuck you. It is now.
You have to give the box and the wine.
Go on.
No, I'm just going to give up the wine.
Thank you.
And then, like, I told my mom, I'll give you the wine. And then I traded the wine for chai tea mix.
I mean, like I said, it's a legit trade.
Yeah.
I probably would have kept, it depends on the wine, but I might have kept the wine.
It was a red wine, and
that was good with meat.
Meh.
I'll do whatever task you want. Red meat.
Meh.
Which I think is really glad to know beef. I can still
disapprove. Meh. It is depends on one.
Depends on the type of wine. Like sometimes it's really fucking sweet. And
oh,
good.
I'm sure. Yeah.
Like Manischewitz, man, that's a red wine. That's goddamn cherry juice.
We appreciate your help. This means a lot.
Try not
to
be a douchebag.
Meryl's like, you can't speak for me. You, punches you.
I hope you will look after her. I can take care
I mean,
of myself.
If Meryl maybe spoke for her fucking yes, self, darling. She wouldn't need me to speak for her.
Avar Tevril has taken the lives of three of our hunters.
Fuck. I didn't think that was. I didn't think it was part of her quest. I thought it was just something you came up upon.
Right, but no, it's actually a part of it.
Fucking course, it's part of your quest.
Do this for us, and I will give you
Solus is like, stop. Stop involving me in everything.
I don't want any of this
I'm
shit.
I'm not the fucking Dread Wolf. God, it's just a name they gave me. You piece of shit.
He's like, I didn't
I saved
kill
you
anyone.
Fuckers. I saved all of you. And I didn't think it was right that homes were like alive forever and ruling forever.
And you all killed Mithal. Or they all killed Mithal.
And then I really drove it home eventually with her and absorbed her power.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see where that one goes.
Okay, so I'm filling out the fucking keep because they added in shit for Inquisition.
Right.
And they had, like, at the very end, cause for some reason, and it was annoying me, they didn't update, like, Descent into it, even though I had Descent.
Which is weird.
Yeah. But they had, like, fucking Trespasser
maybe
up in there.
Because Descent doesn't actually matter.
I mean, it had two spots for the three DLCs.
Oh, okay.
And so, like, well, two spots that were grayed out of the three DLCs.
Right.
And then they had Trespasser.
Hakon and Descent,
yeah,
probably.
Exactly.
Even though I think Hakon came before Trespasser?
Yeah.
Like, Trespasser was the last one, wasn't it?
Yeah. And okay. It's the last on the tabs.
Okay.
I killed this guy. Apparently I didn't.
Looted
him, or maybe it just gave me more loot. But anyway, because maybe it was supposed to kill him now, and then it was like, well, you've done it once, here you go. Yes, I go this way, I believe. I think. Yeah, there's nothing in here.
So,
I think. But anyway, but I was like, it's like, you tried to redeem Solas at the end. And I was like, yep. Or like, did you try to kill him? You know, one of these. And
no.
I was like, he fucking better be like willing to listen to me since I was like super his friend.
Right.
Especially my elf inquisitor fucker. I dated you. And you were
for this?
You pushed out. Yeah.
You're the bitch.
Yeah. Little bitch. And he's like, whoa. Jesus Christ.
You got salty.
Yeah. Well, you know, fucking wouldn't you? I've been salty. Yeah. You little bitch.
Yeah. Well, so we're on that train today.
Yeah. Choo-choo! The little bitch train. All the fucking bored.
People travel between islands much. Not really, no. I wouldn't start waterproofing your wagons then. I don't think Lemerin is ready for the Dalish. What do you mean? Would we upset the people there? It's not the kind of place where one turns down a tumble. Even refuse a fortune teller and they'd run your lot out of town.
All right.
Okay. Guess Meryl is scoping out new living spaces. That was a dude behind that tree for a second. I was like, what?
He's just peeking. His name's Peeping Tom.
I thought you said he was peeking. And I was like, and he's on a peek.
I did say peep, didn't I?
I thought you said peeking, to be honest, so I can't. I mean, and then you went with Peeping Tom, and I was like, what?
I don't know, man. I don't pay attention to half the shit I say.
Excuse me.
This isn't the way we were supposed to go.
Hold on. Did I just, like, massively idiot this? Is he over? Yep. He's over where the Spartars is.
Oh. Well, that would explain why no enemies have been showing up.
Because I killed all of them already, too.
Not true.
I've already been up here looking for... This is just a fucking repeat of the Herbalist Task episode where it was like, kill a Vartel. And then I was like, yeah. No,
all
it's
the way up here.
I was like, well, maybe it's over there. And then it wasn't. And I was like, I fucking probably have to do Meryl's thing.
God damn it.
Yeah.
At least he didn't do a thing in...
At least he didn't have to actually like waste time fighting, though.
At least he didn't do a thing in Symphony where you looked right at the person you needed to go to and then proceeded to waste 45 minutes.
Look, man.
Running all the way back to the beginning point.
They
all the way up the mountain.
That's the one part of the game I hate the most, though, because they never tell you that you should be looking for that there. They
right.
just assume you're going to be talking to goddamn everybody.
Everyone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And like, this is a seller. You're probably going to talk to him. I'm like, no.
No.
I didn't need
doesn't
things.
Doesn't work like that.
Yeah. So like... And they don't even point you in his direction.
No.
So it's like I fucking, like, I didn't know.
That is the little annoying thing about Abyss, too. Like, we need to go to this place.
Okay.
Where is this place?
Yeah.
And it's just like, you'll run around. Like, it wants you to explore, but it's like, I don't want to explore. I just want to be there.
That's why I kind of want to try the new ones and see. Like, that one we were looking at that was, like... nicely rendered,
the one that was realistic.
Yeah I was like, I kind of want to see where that one goes, because maybe they've just gotten better. I mean, we are playing games that were like GameCube PS2 era.
Yeah,
like they're a little old.
It's a little. And I think what the collection I have is the collection on the PS3.
I don't know, actually.
Is it on the PS4
for the Symphonia collection?
Yeah,
that's on the PS3.
Okay, so those two are also on the PS3. Yeah, they
probably
have to be on the PS3 because we played them.
We had to get the fucking...
To get costumes.
Yeah.
Specifically.
You got, like, Grace's F and whatever.
Zestiria?
I don't... Maybe.
Or Zilla.
I think it might have been Zilla.
I think it's Zilla.
Because I think Zestiria is still coming out.
They're
and I was
actually...
like, it's fucking... In...
Oh.
So, it's a game about fucking zesting your food with oranges.
And they're always empty.
they're making a second Radiant World, which is where like they take all the characters from the different games.
I think I told you that they have like Luke and shit in it.
Well, he played the game before on the PSP.
Oh.
But they're making a second one.
Well, I remember telling you at some point that I saw fucking like new shit, like I was browsing the tag for some reason, and like there was a GIF up of something that was like Radiant World 2.
Yeah, so maybe I figured out Radiant World 2 through you.
Yeah. And yeah. I was like, it's not out yet, but like I was like, there's a new fucking game.
Yeah.
Or whatever, but like it's not out. It doesn't, or it's out in Japan, or maybe they're just putting out fucking like ad shit that people are GIFing because it has like Luke and like Zalos.
Right.
And like,
whereas Radiant
has Redhead Extreme.
The one that I have for the PSP has like Kratos in it.
Yeah, naturally.
Yeah. But
I've always meant to, that's the one thing I should do eventually, is because I still have all the files for that, but is draw that one Kratos image that I was gonna draw that goes with the stained glass.
Oh, yes.
Have it be Kratos, Yuen,
what's her name?
Mythos and Martell.
Yeah.
Yeah. But like Mythos as a kid, you know,
right.
So when he was cool. Like their old group essentially, like, but that be all like broken down and shit like that, since it's fucking like back in the day.
That
and
looks been so cool.
Yeah, been like fucking like disregarded and shit like that over the many years, like forgotten or whatever. So everyone else, the new heroes are all fucking nice and cool.
Yeah.
And his, no, they're all degraded.
So cool.
Yeah. But I think I either just didn't feel like I was comfortable, like didn't have the skills for that at the time, or I just got distracted by other shit. Or
I think
tired.
I think you were tired because you pumped. You had to like rush those.
Yeah, a few out.
Sanders. Yeah.
No.
Okay. There was another game I was playing at the same time as Radiant Dawn, called Jewel Summoner. Mm-hmm. If I remember correctly, that's the name of it.
Yeah.
And the main character is voiced by Jade.
Like,
yeah, it's a little awkward because he's like, there we go.
Yeah, I was like, dude, leave me the fuck alone.
Because like the main character's like mid-20s. So it's like fucking Jack Frost and what were the hunters? Guardians, not the Guardians of the Galaxy, but elven
artifacts from the Vartero Guardians of the...
So the
yeah, Guardians of the fucking Holidays, no. Yeah.
Yeah, whatever that one is called. But like how like
it's too many galaxy guardian shit bull going on.
But it's like Jack Frost's voice, like that's way too deep than what I expected from coming out of your face.
Dude. Oh yeah, that was very awkward for me too. But like so I'm watching Rogue One. I'm like, what the hell? Why does that voice sound really fucking familiar in the robot?
Oh.
Like, who? That's it's like a dude that I know, and it's frustrating me because I'm like, I know there's a voice actor, but I don't fucking like, I can't pick
place
it out. Yeah, because it's not like it's a recognizable voice, but it's not recognizable like Troy Baker,
right,
or Nathan Fillion, recognizable,
or Laura Bailey.
Yeah,
or...
exactly. So I'm like, what the hell? And then fucking like the credits run up, and it's like
Alan
Tudyk. I was like, and I didn't even need the fucking like. It was like the first credits before it got to like the character listing,
like,
just
Antic.
I was like, that's who it was.
Yep.
Immediately.
Yeah, like I was like having the same thing, and I was like, I didn't like, it was just more of a, this is a familiar voice.
Yeah,
I'm fine with it. I didn't even like try to place it.
Yeah,
until the credits came up and I saw Alan Tudyk, went, yep,
yeah,
I know exactly who you played.
Yeah, exactly. And I was like I was just fucking like, who the fuck? And like I felt bad because like I said, he does have one of those voices that is recognizable,
but you just can't ever place it.
Yeah, exactly. Like it's like not recognizable enough.
Yeah. Well, if I remember, he's got a fairly decent range too.
Yeah.
Because
I like that he does voice work a lot, to be honest, because
yes,
he is a good voice actor.
He is. Like when he played King Candy, I had no idea it was him.
Yeah.
And going
but
King
like
Candy,
now that you know, you could hear it probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, like I watched Wreck-It Ralph after knowing that I was Alan Tudyk, and you've already calmed down here. There's a door.
Oh yeah, there yeah. was, wasn't there? Man. I fucking like
bleh. But yeah, like there's definitely like a little bit of a point between King Candy that you could hear Alan Tudyk. But going from King Candy to like Weaselton in Zootopia, it's a standard.
I'm saying if any fucking Dingle knows how to open it. Oh, thank God.
Finally.
It took you long enough.
But it's definitely a weird jump.
Yeah.
In characters.
Yeah. Like, still. Decent that he's getting all that work.
Yes. I'm very happy that he's doing voice acting.
I had to remind my mom who he was. And I, but like, I, my dad's never seen the ending of fucking... he has never seen Serenity, so I was like, or like the end of Firefly, really. But like, I was like, yeah, he's the my mom, and I was like, I know the easiest way to get her to remember would be like the guy that got fucking like
wrecked,
stabbed, yeah, right in the end. But I was like, yeah, he's the pilot of in Firefly, and she's like, I was like, he's the one that's funny and shit. She's like, oh yeah, and I was like, the one that you know get. But like, don't not even want it because I want to see my dad wants to watch it because right. he liked it. But like, we for some reason stopped. But I was like,
don't say too much.
And but I'm like, how much? Because my mom's kind of like, if it's not super relevant, she's not. She doesn't hoard information like my dad and I about right. like really obscure things. So it's like, it might not be relevant to her. So I like had to place a couple other like TV shows he's been in that we've seen recently.
Yeah,
so
for her to like, place it.
Yeah, but she knew it. Firefly, fortunately.
Which is good.
Anyway, I think it's a good place to stop.
Definitely.
I'll catch you guys in the next episode of We Stab That Thing Up right
Hell
down there.
Hell yeah.
So until then, bye!